Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the winter concert for Heartland Christian Academy. I think I know most of you. If I don't know you, my name's Jude Nickerson, and I'm the Dean of Students here at Heartland Christian Academy. To all the live streamers, all the family that couldn't make it, hi, welcome, we're glad you're with us. It's going to be a great night. You didn't come to listen to me, you came to listen to the kids, right? As I was walking up, I asked them, are you ready? And they're like, no, we're not ready. Ready or not, here we go.
Thank you. Sixth grade. How about those fifth graders, guys? If you've ever sung a solo by yourself, because that's what solo means, obviously, but if you've ever sung a solo and you stood up here in front of people, they just did that three times on over. Like, they just did that. I think our fifth graders get better and better every single year, and I'm not really sure how that happens. They work really hard. They practice all of the time. It is not hard to get them to practice. They're pretty excited. These sixth graders are the same way. They love to practice. So our songs, it's interesting with smaller bands. So what I've done is I've just separated the parts out, and I've doubled the flute sometimes, maybe, or I've doubled the whoever has the melody. So I'm going to double something, but mainly they're just playing by themselves. Like they're playing their own thing, but they're working together as an ensemble, and that as a musician is very difficult to do and very important. So when we're raising these worshipers, that's what I'm doing, is I'm getting them to be able to be strong enough to play by themselves, but aware enough to listen as they play with other people. So you're gonna hear that with these sixth graders. We're gonna keep on going. We're gonna have to tune each time just because I'm not sure where we're sitting at in this room. Thank you that we got to use the church. It's super cool. And we don't have to set up chairs and tear them down. Thank you guys for coming tonight, for supporting the kids. They're amazing. They're just so fun.
Thank you. Thank you.
Might have been a little focused right there.
So Mrs. Bock needs to focus on what she's doing. So we're going to let her. I don't know about you guys, I'm sitting out there, and every time she comes ready, and all the students come ready with their instruments, I want to sit up in my chair a little bit more, and I want to be ready to hear. And I'm very thankful that we get this opportunity. I'm thankful for Mrs. Bock. I don't know about you guys, but she's a treasure. These are some fine-looking young people, isn't it? Good choice on uniforms, Mrs. Bock. The blue, they are amazing.
All right, it's high school band time, advanced band time. I would say high school, because that would be normal. We have 7th grade through 12th grade represented tonight in this advanced band. It is not normal to put 7th graders up in this band, but these 7th graders can handle it most of the time. So there's, you know, that whole maturity growing thing. That's what band is. That's what learning is that you learn and then you get better and you learn more and you never stop learning. So as long as you keep learning, then you're good. We are going to play some really fun selections tonight. I'm not going to talk too much about them because it's better for all of you if I don't. But I do need to say that I am extremely impressed with these students. When I say, so should we have an extra rehearsal? They say, yes. It is not normal to have kids that are willing to come at 7 a.m. to practice before school starts, just so that the program is pleasing to everybody's ears and that they feel prepared and ready. So that we have high school students and middle school students that are understanding what it means to be prepared and ready and willing to do the extra work that's required. That's maturity beyond years. Because sometimes I don't want to, but when you learn that you don't want to, but you still do, that's where you grow up just a little bit more and a little bit more and a little bit more. Because, I mean, really, if I wanted to, I could sit and watch Hallmark movies all night, and that would be great. But that's not what God's called me to do. And yes, they're the same plot. I still like them. But God's called me to do better than just that. And so because of that, that's why I do what I do. That's what we are all to do what we are to do. Because if not, if I'm going to sit and watch a Hallmark movie, I'm obviously not leading someone to Jesus or letting them know the light. And so that's what this is. That's eventually they're going to play in Brazil or they're going to play in a high school somewhere else. No, not in a high school somewhere else. Please don't do that to me. Please don't move. They're going to teach in a high school somewhere else or teach here. They can teach here. Please teach here. But they're going to do something somewhere else and they're going to affect people that I'm not going to affect. And that's the whole goal, is that when they affect those people, then I am doing my job and that seed has been planted and then they can in turn let other people know Jesus. And that's the whole point. All right. Are we good? Did I?
Thank you.
You deserve every bit of that, guys. That was so much fun. Like when it all comes together and it does all that stuff, like, oh. Listen, on the first song, I'm back here. I'm over here crying. You don't get to see that part, but I'm just like, ah. So, these students are my joy. I can have a rotten day, and I can have them come in, and sometimes it can be rotten still. I'm not going to say it's all rainbows and roses. It's not. But, man, do they work hard. They work so hard, and it is evident. And they are incredible musicians. And I am blessed. Parents, thank you for your support, for your work to tell them to practice, to make sure that they practice. Did you practice? I need to sign this. Did you practice? Hurry up and get it done. It feels like things have been kind of crazy this year because I think we've just had the relaxation of no COVID. I mean, relaxation, you know what I mean, but we've not had much stuff going on, and now we have all the things going on. And I think that we can get caught up in not enjoying things. And so your kids just enjoyed playing. I really hope that they did because it was phenomenal. My soloists, you saw I had lots of soloists because they're amazing. But Jude played that his freshman year? Eighth grade. I threw that on him his eighth grade year, guys. And then I'm like, we need to do this again his senior year. So my senior, Jude, is my only senior this year, and he can stand up. I would say this is your last Christmas concert, but as you can tell, sometimes you might have to come back, so... Jude, you are a joy and a treasure and a leader and someone who follows Christ well. And I thank you for that example for me and for these students. But even more as a musician, you are, you have grown in the past, I don't know how many months we've been in school, 6 months. You have grown even more where you're just like, guys, come on, you can do this. And that's that turnaround whenever someone is... a senior who plays well and works hard, but then is encouraging everyone else to also play well and work hard. And that shift has already happened. That's a blessing. Thank you so much.
Well, gosh, it's hard to follow that. I'm following you. We're going to come back up here. We're not done with you yet. When she has a bad day, often the children don't know it. That's how awesome she is. She exhibits Jesus. What you guys didn't see is backstage before. She prayed over them. And it was awesome. And I have it recorded, and I'm going to send it out to each one of you. No. But it was really good. Her heart is for the success of our children. And it's amazing. And it couldn't be Christmas without one more thing. If you walk over there.
Mrs. Bock, you are an amazing teacher, not just of music, but I mean, you do that really well. Just look at us, we're amazing. But you manage to make us better people by showing us God, whether it's through a little devotion in band class, which I do take to heart, by the way, or just by a little encouraging words here and there, whether it's for basketball, life, or band, you show us how to live a godly life and be a great musician at the same time. So on behalf of the band, we got you this cool gift.
Which you have to open.
It's wrapped really pretty.
It wasn't me who wrapped it.
Yeah, it was Mama that wrapped it. No, you can't sit down yet.
No way! Oh, man, I can't get it off.
She might need some help. Help her out. Oh. You can't, you're not going to pull it.
This is so difficult.
Mr. Metzger, He packaged Mauricio's gift the other night in like 7 boxes. So that's evidently the theme for gifts this year. There we go. There we go. It can be done.
All set together. We love you. We love you, Mrs.
Good job, man. Good job. Good job. Good ad lib. That was awesome. Beforehand, when Jude's like, what are we going to say? When are you going to say? How can I get? He wanted all the details. I said, we're just going to wing it, man. It's more better that way. Well, thank you for coming. Thank you, Mrs. Bock. Thank you, students. All the students that are not on the stage. Thank you. Good work. Strong work. Thank you, live stream, for joining us and all the family there. Thank you, Miss Lori. Thank you, Pastor Chris and the EC for making this an awesome experience for us. Thank you, Pastor Chris, for the church. It's amazing. I'm going to close us in prayer, and then there's a lot of photos that'll probably happen, and there's a big Christmas tree out in the foyer that's a great photo spot. Just hint, hint. Would you bow your heads in prayer with me? Jesus, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this band and all the hard work that went into it. Thank you that they brought you glory. Thank you for coming and saving us from our sins, Jesus. We love you very much. In your name we pray. Amen.